All right, Paul Brawl, and now we know one other match brain. It's going to be Loser Leave WCW, Kevin Sullivan and Cactus Jack one-on-one.
They can both bring their luggage as far as I'm concerned.
Lord Steven Regal will face Johnny B. Badd at Fall Brawl for the television title. By the way, let's remind the fans, this is a big weekend. You know, we have such a tremendous two-hour program here tonight. We talked about the main event tomorrow night at 6:05. If you missed one of the biggest, truly one of the biggest Clash of the Champions events in WCW history, then you can see the replay tonight at 10 o'clock right here on TBS. It's 10 o'clock Eastern Time tonight on TBS.
Tremendous ratings on that show, too.
Tremendous.
But I think the thing people should tune in tonight and watch is watch that mystery man come out of the dark. Watch him waffle Hulk Hogan in the leg with that iron pipe. And you people tell me, you call me Sunday, let me know what you think. I don't think the guy was a guy like they said was Flair's guy. I think it was Hogan's guy. It was a setup. Hogan set Flair up.
And why did he run in the ring at the end of the match?
It might have been a different mask guy. Oh. I don't know. I can't tell mask guys. They wear masks. They all look alike to me.
Well, that makes sense.
Well, you see one, you've seen them all. Just because this guy may have had it for Hogan didn't mean Flair was involved. It might have been a personal thing. Or maybe it was a setup by Hogan again. You gotta watch. You gotta watch him, tell me. You gotta watch him see for yourself. Prove me right.
All right, let's talk about Lord Steven Regal against Johnny B. Badd. It was last week, you remember, they being Lord Steven Regal and Johnny B. Badd, went to the time limit draw here on Saturday night. And then, because of his interference, Johnny B. Badd knocks down with a left-hand punch Sir William. And then Lord Steven Regal demanded, first time I can remember, a champion demanding a challenger, demanded to get Johnny B. Badd in the ring and Fall Brawl again. We have signed it. It is for the television title. It'll be in Roanoke, Virginia. It's going to be quite a matchup.
Well, I don't like the smell of this. I'll tell you why. You can't. Johnny B. Badd's had a few shots at his lordship for the title. You can't let him have too many opportunities. The law of averages will catch up with you. Remember I said Johnny B. Badd was just a hair away from becoming a champion? Maybe he did the right thing. Maybe hitting Sir William caused his lordship to want that match. If that's the plan he came up with, then it worked. And too many times going to the well, it's going to happen. It's not a good move on his lordship's part.
Don't forget fans' comments from Hulk Hogan, his first comment since the injury.
You know what he said? Why me? Why me? Why me? There's Whoopi Armstrong.
Brian Armstrong, that is a very odd looking hair, dude. I would admit that.
No, not if you think about the odd head it's on.
An elbow to the midsection. And there, Rico using the hair to his advantage at times. Uppercut. Oh, and the hair is flopping around now.
You know what I do to him? I fly in mirror him and tie his hair to his ankles and roll him back to Marietta. It'll take you a little while, but it's worth the trip.
Right hand. Regal. Brian Armstrong would just not give up. This youngster, a great second-generation wrestler. Uh-oh, nowhere to go now. Look at that. Leg strength. One,
he's got
two.
Him.
My goodness, almost a win by Brian Armstrong, and a drop toe hold the boot. And he rolls him over.
Well, you know, the Armstrong family is a wrestling family.
No question. Drop kick.
He's got about, what's he got, 70, 40, 50 kids? I don't know.
I don't think. Anyway.
Well, he's got enough for a good parade.
A headbutt. Over the top. And now up on top. Brian Armstrong telegraphed that one. Too much time to let Regal remain prone on the mat. And Regal's going to cover him and may have a win here.
That's
two.
It.
That's it.
He's not going anywhere.
Lord Steven Regal comes away with the win. And it was a defensive win for Lord Steven Regal because this youngster had everything going his way. Regal rolls out of the way. I guess a new term to the Regal roll. And gets the win just by rolling out of the way. Next on deck for Regal is Johnny B. Badd at Fall Brawl by the break.
Look at the height here, old Whoopi Armstrong gets. When he lands on his head, his hair had too much weight. That's wrestler drove him down first like a convoy. It's a little different here now when he's wrestling the board chair. One, two, three, it's over. Come on, Johnny B. Bad. Let's see how bad you really are.
It's triple man.